Dear students, now we are going to discuss about pattern multiplication method and its application with examples.
Pattern multiplication is the method which is mainly used to find out the total field pattern of an array of non-isotropic but similar sources. So here, non-isotropic. This pattern multiplication is mainly used to find out the radiation pattern of the array of non-isotropic sources. In case of isotropic sources, it radiates in all directions. But in case of non-isotropy, the antenna array elements are radiating in a particular directions. So for that array system, we have to use this pattern multiplication method. So here, the total electric field is equal to multiplication of field pattern into addition of phase pattern. So multiplication of field pattern means here we are going to multiply the electric field of the individual element into that array element. For example, consider there are n number of arrays. So here each element can produce individual electric field. So at the distant point in P, we can add all those fields. That is nothing but array electric field in a distant point. So the total electric field can be obtained by the multiplication of field pattern of individual antenna elements and array elements into addition of phase patterns. If we are going to multiply the field, means we are going to add the phase. So this is again the same phase of individual array elements, the phase of the total array elements. Okay, so this is the definition of pattern multiplication. So here we can represent each term as Ei of theta comma phi is nothing but field pattern of individual source. Ea is nothing but array of isotropic point sources. Here we are going to obtain this non-isotropic with respect to isotropic point sources. Okay. So next one is phase pattern of individual source and phase pattern of array of isotropic source. Theta, as you all know that this theta and phi are the spatial coordinate system. So here we represent one more term, that is similar. So similar represents here indication of the variation with absolute angle phi. That is same for amplitude and phase. So we have to ensure similar means it is mainly used to indicate the variation with absolute angle phi, that is same for amplitude and phase. So here we are going to find out the total field pattern of an array of non-isotropy by using the array of isotropic sources. So next, applications of pattern multiplication. So this pattern multiplication method provides a speedy method for sketching the pattern of complicated arrays. When we are talking about complicated arrays contains the non-isotropic sources. Okay, that is what complicated arrays. For that, we can easily sketch the pattern in a speedy way using this pattern multiplication. It is a very useful tool in designing the antenna arrays. The width of the major lobe and the corresponding width of the array pattern both are same. Okay, this we can discuss later with the some examples. Okay, the secondary lobes are determined from the number of nulls in the resultant pattern. The number of nulls in the resultant pattern are equal to sum of nulls of individual pattern and array pattern. So these 3 points we can discuss along with some examples. Let's start with some examples. So here, so in this case, we are having one element here and another element here. Okay, we are not connecting these two elements. These two are the individual elements. Because of these two individual elements separated by the distance lambda by 2 can create the radiation pattern like this. Okay, two individual elements with the distance lambda by 2 can create or radiate the signal like this. Okay, so here consider this one. So here this all are the in phase components. Okay, that is very important. Here this all elements are, this elements are fed with in phase currents, that's why the radiation is perpendicular. Okay, so next one is, suppose the same thing, okay, the same two elements, individual elements, separated by a distance d is equal to lambda with its wavelength, then it can radiate equally in all directions. So its radiation pattern like this. This is all the direction, like this perpendicular direction as well as the horizontal direction, it can radiate equally if it is having the spacing d is equal to lambda. So, and next one, the same individual elements, consider the same individual elements are separated by 2 lambda, then its radiation pattern looks like this. Okay, there are 4 major lobes and 4 side lobes. So, these 3 are very, very important. Based on these 3 concepts, we can draw any radiation pattern of any complicated arrays. Okay, so here, if it is lambda by 2 means it is having only the bidirectional radiation. If it is d is equal to lambda means it can create the radiation pattern like this. If the distance is 2 lambda means it can create the radiation like this. Now we are going to draw the radiation pattern of 4 isotropic element fed in phase spaced lambda by 2 apart. So in this case we are having 4 elements, point sources. Here the distance between the point sources like lambda by 2. This can be drawn like this, 1, 2, 3, 4 elements with the distance lambda by 2. Now we are going to make these 4 elements as a 2 individual elements. Okay, in order to get the pattern multiplication method, we have to convert this 4 element into the 2 elements. How are we going to convert this 4 element into the 2 elements? For that, we can consider this 2 as a single element. So we can combine first and second element as 1 dash and third and fourth element as 2 dash. For that, we can cut the distance, take the average of this 2 element. So what is the average? This point, that is lambda by 2. Half of the lambda by 2 is nothing but lambda by 4. Likewise, this side, half of its distance is nothing but lambda by 4. So we can get this distance, we can keep as such. Okay, so we have combined this 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 alone. So now we have 2 elements, 1 dash and 2 dash, with the distance lambda by 4 plus lambda by 2 plus lambda by 4 is nothing but lambda. So we can convert this array into the 2 individual elements with the space lambda. Okay, so here we can write like this, this 4 element space lambda by 2 have been replaced by 2 units spaced lambda. According to pattern multiplication, the radiation pattern of 4 elements is obtained by multiplying the radiation pattern of individual element and array of 2 points. We are going to obtain like this. So using this pattern multiplication method, so here this is individual pattern due to 2 elements with the space lambda by 2. Correct. This is the individual element pattern with the distance lambda by 2. Here we can draw like this, that is multiplied by, this individual element pattern is multiplied by the group pattern. So we have converted this 4 point 1, 2, 3, 4 into 2 points, that is 1 dash and 2 dash with the distance lambda. So this is the group pattern. This is the individual pattern between 2 elements. This is the group pattern due to array of 2 isotropic sources. We are grouping this. So that can, for lambda means, as we already discussed, its radiation pattern look like this, right? So we are going to multiply these 2 radiation pattern. Then we will get the resultant pattern of 4 isotropic antenna like this. If we are multiplying these 2, obviously we will get the radiation pattern like this. So likewise, now we are going to draw the radiation pattern of 8 isotropic elements fit in phase spaced lambda by 2 apart. So here we are having 8 elements. Spacing is lambda by 2. Correct. So now we are going to convert this 8 elements into 2 elements. That is group pattern. This is nothing but grouping. Okay. So here we have to group the first 4 elements as 1 dash. And group the last 4 elements as 2 dash. Okay. So here we can keep this lambda by 2 SH. Okay. And then this 2 distance can be reduced to 1/4 of its wavelength. Likewise, this 2 can be reduced to 1/4 of its wavelength. So we can obtain 2 lambda. We have to ensure this spacing between the 2 element is the multiple of lambda. Okay. So now this array can be converted into the group of 2 elements with the spacing 2 lambda. So for this we can take the unique pattern. Unique pattern is grouping. So here we can group the 4 elements as a single element. So that is the single element. So 1 dash is a single element, 2 dash is a single element. So here the individual element is nothing but 4 grouping of 4 elements. So unique pattern, here it is N. Okay. The unique pattern due to 4 element, that is individual here. That is given like this. We have just now derived, right? So this is the resultant pattern of 4 isotropic. So this is resultant pattern for 4 isotropic. So now in this we are grouping the 4 elements. So here the individual for this 4 element is like this. And for this grouping of 2 lambda, we convert this 8 elements to 4 elements. For that we can get the group pattern like this for 2 lambda. Multiplying this 2 pattern, we can get resultant pattern like this. Okay. So likewise, we can draw the radiation pattern of any number of isotropic elements. Okay. So this is the simple technique used to find out the radiation pattern of complicated arrays.